It was a creed written into the founding documents that declared the destiny of a nation. Yes, we came. It was whispered by slaves and abolitionists as they blazed the trail toward freedom. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
It was sung.
It was sung by immigrants as they struck out to the distant shore. Pioneers who pushed westward against unforgiving wilderness. Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
It was the call of workers organized. Women who reached for the ballots. A president who chose the moon as our new frontier.
And a king who took us to the mountaintop and pointed the way to the promised land.
Yes, we can, to justice and equality.
Yes, we can.
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 Yes, we can to opportunity and prosperity. Yes, we can to opportunity and prosperity.
Yes, we can heal this nation. Heal this nation.
Yes, we can repair this world.
Repair this world.
Yes, we can.
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 Yes, we can. We know the battle ahead will be long. But always remember that no matter what obstacles stand in our way, nothing can stand in the way of the power of millions of voices calling for change.
We
have been told we cannot do this by a chorus of sinners. It will only grow louder
and more dissonant.
We've been asked to pause for a reality check. We've been warned against offering the people of this nation false hope.
But in the unlikely story that is America, there's never been anything false about hope.
And the hopes of the little girl who goes to the public school in Dillon are the same as the dreams of boy who learns on the streets of LA.
We will remember that there's something happening in America.
That we are not as divided as our politics suggest. That
we are one people.
That we are one nation. And together, we will begin the next great chapter in the American story with three words that will ring from coast to coast, from sea to shining sea. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.